with us. So let's start this community call. Many thanks for joining. We will wait to see if more people join. But so as you saw from the previous comment from Brianna, so you are free to join, to put questions, to comment. So we always have a topic under discussion in these community calls, but we have always our specific moments that we can address your questions or even collect your feedback regarding the different services from OpenAIRE, specifically targeting content providers, so repository managers, query system managers, journal editors, etc. So let's start with this community call. So today the focus will be on the OpenAIRE UsageCounts service to have a more detailed presentation about this service. Now that we can say that so all the main features from this service are in production in a stable and scalable way, so we thought that it was important to present it to you, and also the upcoming plans for the development of this service. But we would like also just to dedicate 3 or 4 minutes also to a new project, OpenAIRE-Nexus project, that will in fact manage some of the OpenAIRE services and integrate these services in the European Open Science Cloud. So I will do this brief presentation about OpenAIRE-Nexus project, and then my colleague Dimitris Pierakos from the Athena Research Center, that is the manager of user statistics service in OpenAIRE Nexus, will detail to you this this service. In our presentations, you can put your questions, but at the end we have a specific moment. About some novelties, usually we always have this slide in the beginning of our calls just to highlight some things from the let's say the recent developments and the different services under the umbrella of Provide, OpenAIRE Provide. So just two highlights from the services. The ones related with the users counts, Dimitris will detail it, but for you to be aware that we finally have all the graphs from the user statistics updated in production, and not only in the Explore service but also in the Provide dashboard. But Dimitris will detail that. About the broker service, if you remember, we did a presentation 1 month ago, and you can also watch the recordings presenting the a service that was developed specifically for this space, in this space Chris solutions, in order to integrate the broker events automatically in those platforms, in repositories or Chris systems using this space Chris or this space software, and we presented in that call the developments that we are doing regarding a broker public API. So the information is completely available already, I think quite well documented. So André is already, my colleague André Vieira, that is also in charge of these community calls, is already sharing the link. We also sent out in the newsletter in the last 2 days an article about this. So if you want to use, be aware that we have this public API. Of course, it can be easily managed and integrated based on the implementation presented one month ago related with this space Chris and this space 7 when released. But it can be also implemented in different software platforms, so be aware of that, and check and do whatever you want. You can contact us in order to get more support, but this is quite important. And we just want to highlight also, as already mentioned, be aware that we do every month the community call. So if you think that there are some topics that you may revisit or see the recordings. As I mentioned in the previous call, you can see the recordings. Usually we put it available in YouTube, in the OpenAIRE YouTube channel, and the links are in this page of the provide community calls. And also the same, if you want to know more about OpenAIRE-Nexus, we did a public launch event last month, and all the recordings and slides are available in this link that we will also put in the chat. Be aware of that, because I will just now do a really brief introduction just for you to be aware that some of the services, and specifically those services that we are mentioning here today, from the provide dashboard, the broker, the validator, and also the statistics, are under development and integration in IOSC within the duration of OpenAIRE-Nexus project. So OpenAIRE-Nexus project, it's a new project. It's an Horizon 2020 project that have started early this year. It's a 30-month project. Basically, it's focused on the integration of some of the OpenAIRE services in IOSC. The type of services that we are integrating in IOSC and delivering these services via IOSC are organized in three portfolios: publish, monitor, and discover. And the different services that we have are a part of the publish or the monitor or the discovery portfolio. It's important to say that the majority of the services that we are talking about are those that are being developed and improve it over the last years in OpenAIRE 2020 or in OpenAIRE Advance. But we are also connecting with additional services. You can see links here like EpiSciences or Open Citations that were not developed by OpenAIRE in the last years. Now we have a connection and we will integrate it in the OpenAIRE services ecosystem. And then the usual suspects that you are aware of: our graph, provide, Zenodo, monitor, connect, are those that already developed, and now we are making this onboarding process in IOSC via the development of this project. This project is one of the five projects that are part of projects that contribute to this onboarding process of IOSC. So there are other projects also developed by other institutions or infrastructures, research infrastructures in Europe, like AGI or others, that are also that have developed projects under the same call, Infra07, to deliver this process of integration. So OpenAIRE-Nexus is one of those services. Okay, just two more slides, just for you to understand. I think it's these community calls are community, so you are part of the community. I think it's also always good to share with you. So the OpenAIRE-Nexus normal structure with a work package related with the coordination and one with dissemination. But I just want to highlight, because here you will see work package 3, 4, 5, and 6. They are really related with the core activities of this project. So the core activity is the integration with the IOSC to provide virtual access to these services, and this is what we are going to develop in the OpenAIRE-Nexus. And then we have a specific work package for each components of the portfolio: one virtual access to publish portfolio, the one related with monitor portfolio, and discover portfolio. And then another slide just for you to understand what are the services that are under these portfolios that we are talking about. And here highlighting also that for the different portfolios, we are also targeting different stakeholders and adding stakeholders to this ecosystem of services from IOSC and specifically the OpenAIRE ecosystem. So publish, we are, you are aware of Zenodo, Amnesia and Argos that were developed within OpenAIRE Advance and OpenAIRE 2020. And now EpiSciences that we will also integrated and linking to our infrastructure. Under monitor, we talk about, of course, the uses counts service that Dimitris will present. Also, the Open Observatory, that is something that were really finalized over the last period of OpenAIRE Advance, and we'll make it publicly. Also, but then we are talking about the monitor service for funders and for research institutions or for research infrastructures. But I think you are aware of the monitor service for funders. And then the also services like open citations on open APCs will be part of this monitor portfolio. The other is the one that where provide is integrated is the Discover. So where we have the Communities Gateway, so the Connect, the OpenAIRE Connect service, the OpenAIRE Explore is the our discovery service, and the OpenAIRE Provide development that will be under this umbrella of Discover. And here, of course, we focus on different services, but the focus will be on the validator, on the broker. The statistics that are part of Provide are a service itself integrated in the monitor. So and what is important to say is that all the features that we have in OpenAIRE Provide, so the validation, the registration process, as Brianna already asked, if so I registered new repositories, if we are going to be able to reply, yes, we are going after Easter. And the enrichments based on the broker, the measure based on the users counts, and then the collection monitoring, the notifications, and all the improvements that we want to do in the monitor collection, the collection monitoring, and also on the notifications integrating also with other kinds of alerts. So will be developed within the coming two years in OpenAIRE Nexus. What is the main objective is just to have provide as a gateway to the European Open Science Cloud. So it's important to highlight that OpenAIRE Nexus is doing this work for different services of OpenAIRE. One of the services is OpenAIRE Provide, and here the idea is that provide can play a key role here on the development of European Open Science Cloud, integrating the different content providers of OpenAIRE also in the AOSC scientific product catalog. We will not be the only way to integrate content, but we are a gateway that are mature enough to contribute to this process. So it's a clear gateway in production already, and having your content, your data sources registered and validated in OpenAIRE, part of OpenAIRE Provide, via OpenAIRE Provide, you can be part of European Open Science Cloud and integrate the EOS scientific product catalog that will benefit from the research graph of OpenAIRE. Okay, I think this is the message that I want to highlight and that we have presented in the OpenAIRE Nexus launch, that if you are interested in know more, I invite you to check some recordings. I know that we always have in our to-do list several recordings to watch, but if you are interested in know more about Nexus, be aware that we have that information. And I can also reply to your questions if needed. If you have questions, you can put it in the chat and try to reply, but at the end we can address those questions. So now I invite Dimitris Pierakos to present to the community all the recent developments and the features from the user statistics service that we have in production. So, and thank you for your availability, Dimitris.
Thank you, Pedro, for the introduction. Let me share my screen.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm Dimitris Pierakos. I work for Athena Research Center. I'd like to welcome you on the OpenAIRE 13th community call. The subject of this community call is the OpenAIRE UsageCounts service, which is a user statistics service of OpenAIRE Research Graph. During the call, we will present an overview of the service, the ways that you can participate, the benefits that you can receive from using the service, and some future enhancements that will be available soon in our service. So, an overview of the UsageCounts service. What is the service is about? The UsageCounts service simply collects raw usage data or user statistics reports for OpenAIRE content providers, for OpenAIRE research graph products, and from the distributed network of OpenAIRE content providers. And this is realized using open standards and protocols. The outcome of this service is the generation of reliable, consolidated, and comparable usage metrics, which are compatible with a counter code of practice standard. Some indicators that show the performance of the service, which is now in a very stable phase. Until March 2021, we have collected statistics information for 3.5 million research products from 200 content providers. And all this information has been manifested in 110 million views and 400 million downloads. Let's see how the service is functioning inside OpenAIRE infrastructure. So in one end, we have the OpenAIRE content providers like institutional repositories, aggregator, data archives, software repositories, etc., that provide content to OpenAIRE infrastructure. To this content, a number of functions are applied, like deduplication, harvesting, mining, and etc., in order to produce what is called the OpenAIRE Research Graph. The main entity of an OpenAIRE Research Graph is the OpenAIRE Research product, which could be a publication, a research data, a software, a funder, a project, etc. So what the UsageCounts service does is simply counts the usage of this research products. And by usage, we mean the number of items, the number of times this product has been viewed, or the number of times the product has been downloaded. And how are we doing this? We have two approaches in order to achieve this. The first approach is called the push approach. It is presented in the top of the side of the graph. So the push approach collects anonymized raw usage activity from content providers like repositories, CRIS journals or CRIS repositories or e-journals. And this is achieved by deploying a set of patches, plugins, or a generic tracker in the content provider site that records usage activity in real time. This usage activity is transferred to our analytics platform, which is based on open source Matomo analytics platform. And then from there, information is transferred and is aggregated using our metadata index in our user statistics database. So this is the first approach, which the push approach. And the second approach is called pool. It's depicted at the bottom of the graph. Using this approach, we gather consolidated statistics reports from aggregation services, for example, AIRE UK, using protocols like SUSILI. These reports are following the standard counter code of practice. So we gather these reports. We aggregate them, we process them, and we store it in our user statistics database. And from there, the user statistics are deployed either in the OpenAIRE's portal, for example, Explore, Provide, or the new UsageCounts service portal, or they are available for retrieval using an API endpoint that also follows the SUSILite protocol. In order to use UsageCounts, you have first you have to register in the Provide platform, and if you perform all these registration tasks, you can view we'll start collecting information, and then you can view the statistics in OpenAIRE infrastructures like Provide, Explore portals, or the new service portal, the usagecounts.openair.eu. And of course, you can get counter reports via SUSILite API following the by using the endpoint that is described in the slide. So in order to register for the service, first of all, you have to register via Provide. You have to register your data source, either it's a literature repository or a data repository or a Zenith or aggregator. And after registering the data source, you have the option to enable the UsageCounts service. And on your side, you have to download the tracking code for your repository platform. You have to configure the tracking code according to the instructions that are provided. And finally, you have to deploy the tracking code in the platform. From our side, as soon as all these tasks are completed, we will validate the installation of the tracking code and inform the repository manager that everything is okay and we have started collecting the information. So when you enable this service, the UsageCounts service, you will receive more detailed information on how to configure the software, the links for the software, and how you can configure it. For example, what kind of, which ID you should put in the trackers, an authentication token, etc. So as soon as you have completed all the registration and we have started collecting all this information, what are the benefits of using this service? We consider the user statistics a measure of scholar impact. We provide indicators that complement other traditional and alternative biometric indicators that in order to provide a comprehensive and most importantly, a most recent view of the impact of academic resources. Just to mention that for some research products like, for example, data sets or software, user statistics is the only available indicator. Metadata duplications, duplication enables accumulation of usage for the same research outputs, and I will provide a more concrete example later. And of course, UsageCounts provides all the required standardization since it follows the counter code of practice directives. Who can benefit from the service? Authors, institutions, open science platforms, funders, and other stakeholders. And all these can find replies to questions like which funder has the biggest engagement in Europe, or give me the evolution of the popularity of the publications or data of the project within a period of time, for example, within the last 5 years. So if you have enabled the service, you can have for your repository, for your content, for data source, in Provide, you can have information like the total number of views and the total number of downloads that have been collected. You can see the evolution, the monthly evolution of the user's activity for your repository. Or you can use you can ask for a particular counter code of practice release for reports like the article report, the item report, etc. So if you decide to get a user statistics report that follows the counter code of practice, you can select, for example, the AIRE-1 report. You can specify the parameters, for example, the date range that you require for the reports, and you will get a list of usage activities, of usage statistics for your repository. We will provide soon a way to download this information from the provider interface. The similar information is also available in Explore, for example, for repository, the Yumino repository that we presented in the previous slide. We have this similar information available in Explore. In Explore, we have also, apart from information in the repository level, we have also information in the item level, and this is the metadata deduplication that I mentioned before. For example, for this publication, we have we can see that we have accumulated information from two different repositories. For example, for this item, this item has been downloaded and viewed in two different repositories. And this information, apart from showing this interface, is also accumulated. In Usage Count portal, you will provide more generic results for the service. For example, you can see how many repositories, how many views, and how many downloads have been collected worldwide. We also have the option to select information for a particular country, not only from Europe, but also for countries like around the world. For example, for Argentina, since we are collecting users' activity from La Referencia aggregator. And you can also see monthly views, monthly views and downloads evolution for this year, for the last 2 years, and the last 5 years. All this information is provided in the Usage Counts portal. And we are also planning to add more advanced analytics. For example, the number of downloads for each funder, or the number of downloads that are related to a particular topic. For example, in this slide, we present the topics that are that follow the archive classification scheme. You can also retrieve statistics, user statistics, using our APIs endpoints. If you go to the Usage Counts service, you will portal, you will find a link to the endpoints, and you can get reports that follow the counter code of practice release 4, and these reports are available in producing results in JSON format, so you can retrieve information and process it in your site. The final and for me the most important development is the release of the counter code of practice, the counter code of practice release 5 reports, which are available in our beta system for testing. You can visit this site and check the available reports. For example, you can see the status of the service. This is one of the reports that are offered by counter code that are offered by counter code of practice release 5. You can see the members that are participating in the usage count service. You can see the reports list that are available. For example, we have the platform master report, the platform usage report, and the platform item report. All these reports are following the directive of counter code of practice release 5. And finally, we are offering the counter data sets report, which is the report that is recommended by the RDA Data Usage Metrics Working Group for reporting usage activity for datasets. So just to recap and close this short presentation, the Usage Counts service provides standards for usage statistics exchange for almost all type of content providers and platforms. It complies to counter-code practice for reliable and comparable reports. I mentioned that we are collecting anonymized usage activity, so we are following GDPR guidelines. We offer global coverage. We cover repositories not only from Europe, but from other countries like South America. We support analysis by APIs and visualization. And if you need further information, you please visit usagecounts.openair.eu and you will find information about the architecture, the APIs, and the analytics that we are offering. So thank you. And if you have any questions, please let me know.
Yeah, thank you, Dimitris. The idea was to do this short overview. I think it was quite good and quite clear. So thank you for that. So if you have questions, please put your questions.
I can see
there are questions here from Alexandra. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I didn't ask, are stats only accumulated from different sources or can be disaggregated from single sources? I don't think I understand exactly what.
Since the stats are for each source, I think it's good. So the user statistics service, Alexander, in provide, so they are for each source. You can have all the views and the downloads for each source. Of course, we have generic numbers. We have also generic numbers in Explore. We have public information in Explore in the Discovery service, but we have specific the possibility to request for specific reports in the provide dashboard for each of the sources of OpenAIRE, for each repository or each service.
Yes,
if I understood well. Mm. Yes.
Yeah. In provide, you can have statistics for individual data sources, and in Explore you can have accumulated statistics on the item level, for example. I don't know if I have replied. Yes, all IPs are anonymized. This is a question from Ariel. All IPs are anonymized, and they are anonymized at the platform side. We do not anonymize it after we receive this information, this records. And all these bots are filtered out using the counter code of practice set of robots that are available. That are updated continuously.
Yeah, thank you for your questions, Alexander and Ariel.
We also have one question in the okay. Google Doc. It's a big question about Greece.
Okay, let me.
Can you ask the question, Andre?
It's a big question. It's about Greece systems.
Can you read it?
Yes. Let me see how I can resume it.
Wow, it's a big question.
Yes, yes.
Share the screen, please.
Okay, that's
more. You think we can reply also the.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Pavel. Yeah, you can jump in, Pavel, if you want, and enable your audio if you want to ask a question.
I'm happy to, Pedro. Thank you. So it's a very long question. Apologies for that.
Happy to
join this kind of monthly open air provider calls. This is the first time I ever managed to make it. I see quite a number of close colleagues and friends. This is a question about CRIS systems as certified providers for open air. Mm-hmm. We have an increasing number of them listed in this URL I have posted on the Google Doc. It's a beta.
Yes.
Web page within the Explorer environment for OpenAIRE. It contains about 15 or so different CRIS systems. From a EuroCRIS perspective, we're closely working with Andreas Czerniak's team at University of Bielefeld in order to kind of identify suitable CRIS systems, harvest their feeds and validate them. It is a kind of test environment yet, because the kind of in production functionality is not yet available, I think, on the provides website for OpenAIRE. But my question is, to what extent CRIS systems are envisioned to become a truly relevant source of metadata for the OpenAIRE research graph in areas like funded projects, where CRIS systems are collecting a lot of information, quite comprehensive information about all kinds of projects, possibly beyond the kind of project information gathering that is taking place through the NOAD network with regard to major national funders. So you can find all sorts of projects in there, kind of privately funded, small organizations. I mean, I was once discussing with Natalia how wonderful it would be if OpenAIRE could provide a bit of a wider snapshot of where the funding is coming from for projects. CRISIS might enable a way to get in this snapshot. The other area where CRIS systems could be relevant for the OpenAIRE research graph is research data sets, specifically in the domain of the EOSC, because many institutions, among them my own one, the University of Strathclyde in Glasgow, are keeping their research data sets in their CRIS systems. And because these are not data repositories, they tend not to be registered in directories like RE3 data. Effectively, for a data set aggregation like OpenAIRE, if we manage to get the input from CRIS systems into the OpenAIRE research graph beyond publications and into these other areas like research data sets or funded projects, services like the OpenAIRE broker for enriching repository records could become far more effective, I would expect, because you would have all these metadata that are otherwise absent from the current aggregation. So this is a question about what the plans may be for integrating the input from CRIS systems into the OpenAIRE research graph, so that we can use this information to promote registration and validation of CRIS systems with the OpenAIRE provides base.
Yeah, thank you, Sam. Many thanks, Pablo, for your question and for being part of this community calls also, which is good. One previous, I can, if Andreas then want to add something, but I can just give some highlights for this for this talk with you. One important thing is that, okay, for sure, CRIS systems are part of OpenAIRE and we want them to be part of OpenAIRE. We also, as a result of the collaboration with you and the EuroCRIS, so we also want to have an authoritative directory for the registration of CRIS systems. And in fact, we took already the decision about that, having DRIS, your directory, as the authoritative source. And this is the first step, I think, which is important. What we really need to do is to put this in production in the workflow of registration of CRIS systems. And this is something that we really want to do it as soon as possible. And we have already started to with the first steps for that. It's important to say that in some of the provide management team meetings that we have biweekly, we have already discussed that we should have one call, one of the upcoming calls dedicated only to CRIS systems. But we wanted to have that when we want when we release the registration workflow in provide, because then we formally can say that please be part of this directory to be part of OpenAIRE and follow this step. And we want to have that. So be aware that we will have a call dedicated, and for sure you will be invited also to say some words. So the first reply from my side is that, okay, let's put in place this formal way to integrate CRIS systems in OpenAIRE, having a proper workflow in an authoritative directory that will be DRIS. And then let's formally say to the world, we count on CRIS systems to be part of OpenAIRE. Then, I think this is the first and the easier answer. Then the rest is important. Being part of OpenAIRE which means that you can register CRIS system providing metadata from publications or data without being registered in RISC data. So we need them to solve that part, but we are in fact doing that in OpenAIRE for other reasons. But so you have this issue of CRIS systems that also have data, and we have the same for other repositories that are becoming institutional repositories that are becoming hybrid repositories, and where we can have software, publications, theses, and data. So we have the same issue, and we want to avoid having the like two registrations processes to have the same repositories providing publications, literature, and providing data. So we will have the same situation for CRIS. We need to solve it, but we are going to solve it. But having the workflow for registration, we have the first step to solve this issue solved, let's say. What is missing from my reply? The project information, funder, project information. Yes, CRIS systems will be quite important to enrich our information from funders, from projects, etc. Having you registering, following the guidelines, we will also do the first step to improve our graph, based on your input to what concerns project information. And I think this is quite important. And even organization, also information, etc. That is will be also helpful to improve our research graph. So for this, I don't have a clear reply for the project information, the way that we are going to collecting to enrich our graph. To collect is easy, to follow guidelines, we will collect the metadata, but then use that information also to enrich our graph and to populate our, let's say, authoritative sources of information for projects that we now on have based only on the data that we receive from funders. Okay, it's we need to work on that, but for sure we will solve, because this is important. So the information that we are going to collect from you. Are you happy with my reply, Pablo, or not? Feel free to ask or to ask for more information. This is what we can say, and I think it's important. If we, I really want to have My idea, and I'm pushing for that, is to have a call dedicated to CRIS system, one of these calls dedicated to CRIS systems in the first semester. It will be difficult to have in May, but in June, if possible, we should have it. Which means that we should have, by the first Wednesday of June, the registration workflow already solved and working with your API from DRIS. If it is possible, we can do the call in June. Okay. Thank you, Pablo. Okay. Thank you. And then for statistics, I don't know what can we do for in terms of statistics for CRIS systems, but we can discuss also in that call specifically. I think this call will be also helpful to let's say to discuss all issues from the integration of CRIS systems in OpenAIRE regarding metadata, but also other kinds of things. But if Andreas and Dimitris want to join and to say something more, then Andreas, do you want to?
Yes.
Are you happy with my reply? Or?
I agree with you regarding that we should have. A dedicated call to the integration of CRIS systems and the benefits for CRIS systems from OpenAIRE. Regarding the usage statistics, the DSpace CRIS implementation that are at GitHub integrates the usage statistics add-on from Dimitris. So this is in the DSpace CRIS part of out of the box, let us say. So it is integrated and can also directly used in the other cases. We should take a closer look if our techniques and tool sets that we have could fit these cases or issues.
Okay. Thank you. One of the things that I missed, I took a note in the comments to Pablo question, but I think it's also useful for all, not only for those that are managing CRIS systems. It's that OpenAIRE is in contact also with the directories, as we have directories as alternative source for registration currently. Currently, RE3 data for data repositories and open door for publications, but we are being contacted by others, and we want to have DRIS, the directory of EuroCRIS. I don't know if I can mention like this, so Pablo, you can say. And for example, Fair Sharing that also have contact OpenAIRE. So the OpenAIRE is in contact with these directories also to provide feedback and to work with them in order to improve the processes of ingesting information, the improvements regarding APIs, improvements also to have a kind of common framework of metadata that we can share, because OpenAIRE will be the entry point to the gateway to AOSC, and we also want to have the directories following like the same framework that we are following in order to make this more easier and simple. So be aware that we are also working with OpenDoor and RE3 data, and be aware that I know that they are also aware of the needs of the community. And so regarding when we are talking about CRIS systems having data information, data sets, RE3 data is for sure is aware of that, and is also, and I know that they are taking that into consideration in some changes that they are doing, and that they have presented to us in a meeting that we had recently. Important to say that regarding this, that OpenAIRE now is also part of the Open Door Steering Committee, and that Open Door is really a community-driven service, is becoming a community-driven service. So all these directories that are the authoritative sources for OpenAIRE are quite relevant, and it's quite important that OpenAIRE also be in touch with them. And the same for trees are the same for R3 data and Open Door. Okay, we are coming to the end. Okay, thank you, Pablo, to share this because I was talking about trees, and trees is something new. So thank you for sharing the link here. So Pablo already shared the link to the directory of Chris systems available, which was good, and they have also now a way to be integrated in with OpenAIRE. So hopefully we will manage that in the coming months and present it publicly in a community call that will for sure prepare in advance. Dimitris, do you want to say something more about the statistics? Any additional information before we close the call?
I'm just replying to Liliana from the University of Belgrade about the Serbian repositories. Regarding the list of Serbian repositories, I have provided the link to the list of all members in our new counter code of practice release 5 endpoint. But unfortunately, the counter code of practice for this particular report does not specify the country. So I will send you the list by email.
Okay, thank you. Before we finish, just two informations. Be aware, as I know that every time we organize a call, we have newcomers. Sometimes we have more than 60 or 50 participants. Today we only have a little bit more than 20. But be aware that if you have any issue accessing the provide based on any problem with the login, you are not sure about who did the registration, etc., just contact, you can contact the help desk, but in order to solve it quickly, my colleague André will share the email. We always do the same in every call. So you can contact him directly and we will solve it quickly. If you have any issue with accessing, because we are aware that sometimes there are issues because people change from the ones that did first time the registration in OpenAIRE. So be aware of that. My colleague André, you can contact him. And of course, join the community calls. Subscribe the newsletter because then with the newsletter, I think it's good if you just want to share here the slide. So it's good if you also subscribe the newsletter because every first Monday or Tuesday of the month, we send out this newsletter just before the community call with the novelties. So subscribe the newsletter, have all emails that are part of provide service, they receive this, but you can also subscribe individually if you want. And all the recordings are in the provide community calls page. So be aware of that. You can also look to previous presentations and recordings and slides. So many thanks for your, if you don't have any other question or comment, I'm going to close the call. And many thanks for joining, Dimitris. Many thanks for your contribution to this call. You are part of the team, but it's also good, always good to say thanks. And thank you all for your questions and in presence here. And we'll wait for you in the first Wednesday of May. We are going to do another call. So if you have any need or any request, so you can contact us via email or via the help desk service. Many thanks. Bye-bye.